Hi friends, in this video I am going to discuss about induction motor. Three-phase squirrel cage induction motor are widely used in industries because of its three properties. First one, it is self-starting. Second one, it is reliable. And finally, it is economical. Single-phase induction motor widely used in small loads such as household applications. Example, fans, blowers, centrifugal pumps, etc. In this video, we are going to discuss about the construction of three-phase induction motor. Three-phase induction motor has basically two parts, stator and rotor. Apart from these, it has other parts such as shaft for transmitting the torque to load. This shaft is made up of steel. We connect load according to our requirement to this shaft. Next, the bearing for supporting the rotating shaft. Third one is, one of the problem with electrical motor is production of heat during its rotation. To overcome this problem, we need a fan for cooling. Number four, for receiving external electrical connection, terminal box is needed. Number five, there is a small distance between the rotor and the stator, which usually varies from 0.4 mm to 4 mm. Such a distance is called air gap. So first we are going to discuss about the stator of a three-phase induction motor, which is basically has three main parts: stator frame, stator core, and stator winding or field winding. Stator frame, it is the outer part of three-phase induction motor. Its main function is to support the stator core and the field winding. It acts as covering, it provides protection and mechanical strength to all the inner parts of the induction motor. The frame is either made up of die-cast or fabricated steel. The frame of three-phase induction motor should be strong and rigid, as the air gap length of three-phase induction motor is very small. Otherwise, the rotor will not remain concentric with the stator, which will give rise to an unbalanced magnetic pull. The main function of a stator core is to carry the alternating flux. In order to reduce eddy current loss, the stator core is laminated. These laminated type structure are made up of stamping, which is about 0.4 to 0.5 mm thick. All the stampings are stamped together to form stator core, which is then housed in a stator frame. The stamping is made up of silicon steel, which helps to reduce hysteresis loss occurring in the motor. Next, we are going to discuss about stator winding or field winding. The slot on the periphery of the stator core of three-phase induction motor carry three-phase winding. We apply three-phase AC supply to this three-phase winding. These three-phase winding are connected either in star or delta, depending upon which type of starting method we use. We start squirrel cage induction motor mostly with star delta stator, and hence the stator of squirrel cage induction motor is delta connected. We start the slip ring three phase induction motor by inserting resistance. So the stator winding of a slip ring induction motor can be connected either in star or delta. The winding wound on the stator of three-phase induction motor is also called field winding. When this winding is excited by three-phase AC supply, it produces rotating magnetic field. According to the type of rotor, induction motor are basically two types. First one is squirrel cage induction motor, second one is slip ring induction motor. The rotor of a squirrel cage type three-phase induction motor is cylindrical, have slot on its periphery. The slots are not made parallel to each other but are bit skewed. As the skewing prevent magnetic locking of the stator and the rotor teeth and make the working of the motor smooth and quiet. The squirrel cage rotor consists of aluminium, brass, copper bar. These aluminium, brass and copper bar are called rotor conductor and are placed in the slot of the periphery of the rotor. The rotor conductor are permanently sorted by copper or aluminium ring. called in to provide mechanical strength. These rotor conductors are braced to end ring and hence form a complete closed circuit resembling like a cage. Hence got its name squirrel cage induction motor. The squirrel cage rotor winding is made symmetrical. As end ring permanently short the bars, the rotor resistance is quite small and it is not possible to add external resistance to the bar to get permanently shorted. The absence of slip ring and brass make the construction of squirrel cage three-phase induction motor very simple and robust, hence widely used in three-phase induction motor. The motor has advantage of adopting any number of pole spare. The advantage of squirrel cage induction motor is its construction is very simple and rugged. There are no brushes and slip ring. This motor requires less maintenance. Mainly in drilling machine, lathe, fan, blower printing machine, squirrel cage induction motor is used. Next, we are going to discuss about the second type of induction motor, slip ring or wound type 3-phase induction motor. In this type of 3-phase induction motor, rotor is wound for the same number of poles as that of stator, but it has less number of slot and has fewer turns per phase of a heavier conductor. The rotor also carries star or delta winding similar to that of stator winding. Rotor consists of number of slot and the rotor winding are placed inside the slot. The three end terminals are connected together to form star connection. As its name indicates, three-phase slip ring induction motor consists of slip ring connected to same shaft as that of rotor. The three end of three-phase induction motor are permanently connected to three slip rings. The external resistance can be easily connected through the brushes and slip ring, hence used for speed controlling and improving the starting torque of three-phase induction motor. The brushes are used to carry current and to form rotor winding. These brushes are further connected to three-phase star connected resistance. At starting, the resistance is connected to the rotor circuit and gets gradually cut out as the rotor picks up its speed. When motor is running, slip rings are shorted by connecting metal collar, which connect all the slip rings together, and brushes are removed. These reduce wear and the tear of the brush. Due to the presence of slip ring and brushes, the rotor construction becomes somewhat complicated. Therefore, it is less used as compared to squirrel cage induction motor. But the advantage of the slip ring induction motor is it has high starting torque and low starting current. Possibility of adding additional resistance to control the speed. Mainly hoist, crane, elevator, slip ring induction motor is used.